Hey guys, this is Prachi and I'm a business developer in Bagisto. First of all, welcome to all in our webinar. Today, just few minutes ago, we launched our most awaited mega release of Bagisto version 1.0.0 with our wonderful velocity theme. So guys, before going to start with my webinar or like with the major changes we have done in our release, I'll show you from where you will get this file. So guys, hope you can see, this is our Bagisto website, and in the right side at the top you can find this download button. You just need to click on this download button. Once you click on this download button, then you will be directed to this page, and here you can see this download symbol, and here you can download the latest or the stable version of Bagisto, which is 1.0.0. Not only from the Bagisto website, you can also get this file from the Bagisto GitHub repository page. In the Google, you just need to type Bagisto and GitHub. Here. So guys, as you can see, just 1 hour ago we have released our mega version 1.0.0, and from this you can get the zip file of our mega release. And we also merged the migration guide in our documentation, Bagisto documentation. Simple, you can write over the Google Bagisto documentation, then you can find the Bagisto doc. And here you can see in the index, update in Bagisto version 1.0.0. So guys, here you can see create your own product type. So this is the one of the plus point in our release, like create your own product type. This allows the store owner to create their own, and according to their requirement they can create the any kind of product, including the virtual product, group product, downloadable product and bundle product. Next is backward incompatible changes. Here you can see all the incompatible changes. And then upgrading to Bagisto 1.0.0 from 0.2.2. Guys, because most of our customers are currently using 0.2.2 version, so this guide is majorly for those our lovely customer who will move to the 1.0.0. So this is the guide where they can see all the steps from follow this, they can easily move from 0.2.2 to 1.0.0. Now let's move on to our PPT. So guys, these are four major changes, like four new product type we have added in our major release. Installing Bagisto via single command. Literally, believe me guys, you can easily install the Bagisto file in your local host or in your live. You can simply install the Bagisto via just running a single command. Later on, I will let you know what is this command is. Then velocity theme, I'll show you the velocity theme and adoption of Laravel 6. So guys, the first product type is we added in our major release, group product. Group product is just simple, the collection of simple product or the standalone product in our group. where the customer or the end user can buy according to their need. They can buy a product at separate or they can buy the product as in a group. It totally depends on the customer choice. And for the store owner, they have the facility or the dynamic function where they can combine the simple product in a new group. So as I mentioned, according to the definition, a group product consists of simple standalone product that are presented as a group. You can offer variation of a single product or group them season or theme. Presenting a group product can create an incentive for customer to purchase additional item. A group product provides an easy way to offer variation of a product and list them all on the same page. This is not just guys, we have already posted our video in our YouTube channel. Let me show you from where you can get the video. You just need to go to the YouTube and just type the Bagisto. So this is our Bagisto channel guys. You can subscribe our channel so that whenever new video will come, you will get the notification. Hope you guys can see, these are our video, like how to create downloadable product in Bagisto, how to create virtual product, how to create group product. So soon we will post the another video, like how to create a bundle product by maybe by today evening. And now next in the row is downloadable product. Guys, this is very simple to understand the downloadable product, because downloadable product are same like what this sounds, something which you can download. Like a downloadable product can be anything that you can deliver as a file, such an e-music, ebook, music, video, software application or update. You can offer an album for sale and sell each song individually. You can also use a downloadable product to deliver an electronic version of your product catalog. Virtual product. Guys, virtual products are totally intangible in nature, and this is virtual products are also called as a digital product. This allow you, the store owner, to sell the intangible or the digital product over their store. And in this, they are just selling membership, subscription plans, warranty, and digital products like music, videos, ebooks. Virtual product can be sold individually or included as a part of group product or bundle product types. Last in the row is bundle product. Guys, bundle product is a bundle your own customizable product. Each item in a bundle can be based on the following type, like simple product and variants of configurable product. Bundle product allows the store owner a give a facility where they can create a customizable product. This is not necessary, they just use like collection of simple product. They can customize their product according to their need. Later on I will show you how to create a virtual product and a group product in Bagisto. Next in the row is install Bagisto via single command. So guys, this is this command, php artisan bagisto colon install. By just running this single command, the whole Bagisto file will be successfully downloaded in your local host. So now let's move on to the terminal to download our file, to download the Bagisto. So guys, because I have already downloaded the Bagisto file from the GitHub page and pasted in my root directory, so I'll just get into my root directory first. So now I am into my file, Bagisto file. Then I will run the composer install. So guys, as you can see how fast all the dependencies are downloading. So here we have to run our first and last command to download our Bagisto file, which is php artisan bagisto colon install. Here you have to mention your database name, because guys, I have already created my database. Then I'll just mention my database name here. Then this will ask you what is your database username, what is your database password, and here we go. Guys, this will take you 2 or 3 minutes to download the all files. So before this will be going to download, we just move to the our PPT. So guys, next in the row is velocity theme, because our file is taking 2 or 3 minutes to download successfully. I'll show you and describe you how what's the look of velocity theme is. So guys, as you can see, this is the wonderful dashboard of Bagisto. Here to change the Bagisto front end, because let me show you first what is the front end right now. And guys, this is the default theme. As you can see, this is our Bagisto default theme. Now I will show you how you can change the default theme to velocity theme. For this, you just need to go to the settings. Guys, under the setting you will find the subsection as channels. Under the channel, this is my current channel, which is a default channel. Here we need to edit our channel. Now guys, under the channel setting you will find a section as design, and under the design section you can see the subsection as theme, and here under the drop down you will find another theme as velocity. So we just need to select the velocity theme, and then we will click on the save channel button. So guys, here is our channel updated successfully. Now let's move on to the front end, where we will see our velocity theme. Let me refresh the page. So guys, here is the beautiful and most awaited theme of Bagisto. It is a velocity theme. As you can see guys, this is a very impressive theme. As you can see, there is a slider. These are the home content, where you will find the 4 advertisement images. These are the featured product, and these are some return policies. These are another advertisement section. This is the section for new product. And this is our footer content. So now let's move on to the backend again. So guys, under the backend section at the left hand side is another section as velocity. So now let's move on to the velocity. So guys, once you click on the velocity section, you will find 2 subsection as metadata and header content. Guys, under the metadata you will find some journal settings at like activate slider. So once you activate the slider, you will find this slider over your front end, and if you just inactivate it, then this slider will automatically remove from here. Then sidebar category. Guys, as you can see, this is my sidebar category, and here let's suppose I mention here number 2, then I'll click to update metadata. So guys, what will happen into the front end? As you can see right now, six categories are visible in the sidebar category. Once I refresh my page, because I have done few settings in the back end, I mention here two as a sidebar category. So what you can see guys, only two category will be visible here. So this setting is for sidebar category. How much number I saved here, this will reflect over the front end. Let's suppose if I save here 8 and then my category in the back end are 20, then in this case guys, only 8 category will be visible in the front end. And next is featured product. So guys, as I shown you before, this is the featured product section. If I mention here 5, then only 5 product will be visible at the front end under the feature product section. This is new product section. So guys, the same settings will be goes with the new product section. If I mention here, let's suppose if I mention here 2, then I'll click on update metadata here. In this case, only 2 product will be displayed in the new product section, as you can see. So guys, this is very simple and easy to manage your new product and feature product section in Velocity theme. This is fully dynamic and this will give you a very good user experience. Yes, then guys, as you can see, the next setting is home page content. So guys, this is all our home page content, as you can see. So from this section, home page content section, admin and the store owner can easily modify this content according to their need. Then product policy, as you can see, we have free shipping, product replace and return available, product exchange and EMI available. So these settings are displayed here. So here the store owner or the admin of the store can easily modify these product policy settings. Next is the image settings. Guys, under the image settings, advertisement 4 image, advertisement 3 image, advertisement 2 image. No matter how much images you will add in this section, but because you can add multiple images here, but only 4 images will be displayed here. As you can see guys, these are the advertisement images. This is a section where you can find the 4 images, and this is a section where you will find the 3 images. You can easily modify the size of the images, and you can easily modify the content of the images. And this is the section for 2 images, as you can see guys. Next is the footer section. Under the footer section guys, you can see subscription bar content. So this is a subscription bar, as you can see. This is a navy blue section, is a subscription bar section. Let's suppose admin entered something here. And then they will click on the update metadata. So guys, as you can see, this content will be visible here. Then this is under the footer section, you will find the footer left content and footer middle content. So guys, this is our footer left content, this is our footer middle content. So this is very easy for the admin to manage their Velocity theme, where they can manage the featured product, they can manage the new product, they can also manage the categories, and they can manage their home page content, product policy and images, subscription bar content, footer content as well they can manage. Now let's move on to the header content. So guys, under the header content, this is the few list of content like music, menswear. So let me show you at the front end. So guys, as you can see, menswear and music. So here, what guys, now let's click on the add content here. Once you click on the add content, then you will find the new page as title. Let's suppose, guys, here what you can do, you can link your category with this header content. No matter, you will put as your category name, the same name, what is your category. You can also define any other name. Let's suppose I am just putting today's deal. Next, you have to define the position, then status, then content type, category slug. Because guys, in today's deal, let's suppose I'm going to offer like big discount on my women's wear category. So what you have to mention here, you have to mention the category slug here, and my women's category slug is women's hyphen wear. Then I have to mention the same here. Then you will find the new setting as page link target. Here what you can do, the self and new tab. If you like choose self, then once the customer will click on the your title like today's deal, then on a same page the next page will be appears. If you choose the new tab, then the new tab will be open. Now let's click on the save content here, and here is the message, success message, content page created successfully. Now let's move on to the front end to check the settings, what we have done. So guys, as you can see, today's deal is appear at the header point. Now let's click on the today's deal. So guys, as you can see, because I have chosen the new tab, that's where new tab is appear. The women's wear category is appear on a new tab. So guys, hope you understand. This is very easy and simple to manage the velocity theme. This will give you a very good experience to the user and the admin as well. They can manage their header content, footer content, they can manage their feature product, new product, they can manage the sliders, they can manage the categories. So now let's check our Bagisto file. Because it's like more than 4 minutes we have taken, and our file must be downloaded. So now let's move on to the terminal to check. So guys, as you can see, our Bagisto file is successfully downloaded. Now let's move on to the Chrome, where we will see our file or our Bagisto. So this is my localhost. Here I have downloaded the Bagisto file. So now let's click on the Bagisto file here. Once you click on the Bagisto file, now let's go with the public file here. So guys, here is our front end. As you can see, our Bagisto file is downloaded successfully. I just run a single command over the terminal, just php artisan bagisto colon install, and as you can see guys, my file is successfully downloaded. You can see this is the front end of Bagisto, and here you can see the footer content of Bagisto. Here you can see the locale section as well. So guys, this is very simple and easy to download the Bagisto. You just need to run a single command into your terminal and you will have your e-commerce site ready. So now let's move on to the PPT. So next in the row is, guys, Bagisto moved from Laravel 5.6 to Laravel 6. So guys, this is one of another plus point, and which is like a good point for us, because we have moved from 5.6 to Laravel 6, which speed up the performance of Bagisto and remove like various things which are like not necessary or which is like interrupting somewhere. So in our next webinar, we will come with what all our major changes, or like how we optimize our Bagisto from with Laravel 6. We are also having our blog in our Bagisto website. You can look out there, like what all major changes we have done by adopting the Laravel 6. So now guys, this is all about my PPT, because I promise you, I'll show you how you will create the virtual product and how you will create the group product in Bagisto. So now let's move on to the backend of Bagisto, where we will see how we can create a virtual product. So guys, to create the product in Bagisto, we have to go to the catalog section. Under the catalog section, we will just go to the add product section. And once you click on the add product section, you will find few journal settings where you can choose the product type. So guys, here you will find the 6 product type. Like option, simple product, configurable product, virtual product, group product, downloadable product, and bundle product. So because I'm going to create a virtual product, so now let's click on the virtual, then attribute family. Guys, I have not created any attribute family as of now, but you can create your own attribute and attribute family. Then you can simply choose that attribute family from this drop down. Then I'll enter the SKU of the product, which is always be a unique number for every product. So here is our product is created. Now we have to give the detail information about the product, because guys, this is a virtual product. Then I'll going to add a kind of premium membership for my customer. Once you enter the name of the product, then URL key will automatically enter. And if you have created any kind of text category in Bagisto, then you can simply choose that text category from this drop down. Then you will find the toggle button, 5 new toggle button, like new, featured, visible individually, status, guest checkout. So guys, if you wanted to show your product at the front end in the new product section, then you can enable the new button. If you wanted to show your product in a feature section, then you can enable this featured toggle button, visible individually, which is very necessary to enable this button, and status, guest checkout. If you want, like guest customer can also buy your virtual product, then you need to enable this toggle button. And these are some default attribute guys, because I have not created any kind of attribute here, that's why. And I have chosen the default family, that's why these attributes are visible here. Then description, here you will find like description settings where you can describe about your product. Then you will find the meta description. Guys, the meta description will help you to enhance your SEO of the product. So you have to mention the meta description according to your product, specification, then price of the product, inventory. Guys, if you have not mentioned any inventory, then your product will be visible as out of stock at your front end. Then here you can add the image for your virtual product. Guys, you can also add the multiple images here. Then category, because this is a virtual product, so I am choosing a premium membership, because guys, always we have to choose the category according and with the respect of our product, which will help the customer to find out the product. Then we will choose the channel. Here I am choosing the default channel. Then linked product. Guys, we are having a separate video where you can see, and blog also, how you can manage the upselling, cross-selling and related product section. Then I'll click on the save product button here. So here is our success message, product updated successfully. Now let's move on to the front end. So guys, as you can see, premium membership, this is my virtual product which I recently created. As you can see, guys, this is very easy to create a virtual product or any kind of product in Bagisto. And here at the front end, we are having a new feature in velocity theme where you can just have a quick view of a product by just hitting this quick view button. As you can see guys, here before going to the product page, you can easily find the information about the product in a quick view as well. And you just simply click on the add to cart button, then product will add it to your cart. Now let's move on to the backend where we will see how we'll create the group product. So guys, as I mentioned before, group product is a combination of simple product because I have already have a simple product in my front end. Let me show you, like men's trouser, men's shoe, men's t-shirt. So I am just going to combine these three products in a set of men casual wear while creating a group product. Now let's click on the add product button here, and again you will find this journal setting where you can choose the group from the product type, because here we are creating a group product. Then we have to choose the attribute family, then we have to enter the SKU of the product. Now let's click on the save product button here. So guys, because I'm creating a group product, then I'm just, my product name is set of men's casual wear. And if you have the text categories, then you can choose the text category from this drop down. And I'm enabling all these toggle button, new, featured, visible individually, status, guest checkouts. Yes, I want like guest customer can also buy my product. Then we have to enter the description here about the product. Guys, description of the product will help you to provide a good information about your product to the customer. Then meta description, here image, you can add the image for your product. Guys, you can always add the multiple image whenever you are creating any kind of product. Then here we will choose the category for our product. I'll choose the menswear here. Then group product. Guys, this is the most important section in the process of creating group product, because here you will find the subsection as search product. Guys, once you type the three starting letter of the product, then the product will be appear in this search section. Let's suppose I am just entering men's, because this is a set of men casual wear, so I am going to add the men's collection here. Like I am going to add the three product, a men's trouser. As you can see guys, I just simply click on the product and then this product is automatically added here. Then I add the another product, men's t-shirt. Then last but not the least, men's shoe. So guys, hope you can see, this is very simple to adding any product, any simple product into the group product. You just need to enter the starting three letter of the product, then the same product will appear in the search. Then you can simply click on the product, then automatically the product will be added to your group product section. So here, this is the SKU of the product and this is the quantity. So guys, this is the default quantity basically. So I'm just updating my default quantity from 1, because guys, if I have entered here 5, and at the front end, once the customer will click on the add to cart button, then 5 quantity of a men's trouser will automatically added to their cart. So that's why I'm just mentioning only 1, But obviously customer will have the flexibility, they can increase the quantity according to their need. And next you will specify the sort order section here. Then we will choose the channel and linked product. Now let's click on the save product button here. So guys, here our success message, product updated successfully. Now let's move on to the front end to check our group product. So guys, as you can see, this is my group product which I recently added, set of men's casual wear. Now let's click on the product. So guys, here you can see the three products which I added in a group, which is men's trouser, men's t-shirt, men's shoes, and this is the quantity. This is displayed one because I have entered the one single quantity in the default quantity section. As you can see, here I mention a one quantity, and accordingly the same is appear at the front end. If I mention here two, then two quantity will be appear here. And once the customer will click on the add to cart, they can simply buy the product. And guys, in the group product, customer having the like facility, they can buy all the product in a group, or they can buy a single product as well by just decreasing the quantity of the another product. And they, once they will click on the add to cart button, only men's trouser will add to the customer cart. So guys, hope you understand, this is very simple and easy to add a different kind of a product, like virtual product, group product, downloadable product, bundle product in Bagisto. And I have also shown you from where you will get the like latest version or the mega version 1.0.0 from our like GitHub page, from the Bagisto website. So guys, that's all about our webinar. Soon we will come with the another webinar with our new releases or new changes. Till then, keep watching and stay connected. Thanks.